Hello students, in this presentation I will be discussing about sericulture and silk varieties. Before starting my presentation, I would like to mention that this presentation is the part of the initiative taken up by the Zoological Society of Assam to reach out mainly the students of zoology. The presentation has been designed to address about sericulture and silk varieties, which will help us to better understand what is sericulture and silk, history of sericulture and about silk root, different types of silkworms, varieties of silk, biodiversity of wild silk moth in northeastern region of India, importance of silk, and finally recent research approaches. So let us start my presentation on sericulture and silk varieties. So what is sericulture and silk? The production of silk from the silkworm by rearing practices in commercial scale is called sericulture. The word sericulture is derived from two Latin words, sericus means silk and culturi means to cultivate. On the other hand, the animal fiber silk is a protein fiber produced by silkworm consisting of two types of proteins, namely silk fibrin and silk sericin. Although silk is a very beautiful and fancy gift of nature, but its commercial production is very much complicated and tough job which requires heavy manpower. There are four major varieties of silk, that is Malabari, Muga, Eri and Tassar, of commercial importance, obtained from different species of silkworm. Except Malabari, other varieties of silk are termed as non-Malabari. All these silk-producing insects or sericigenous insects belong to moth group of order Lepidoptera. All the moths are close relatives of butterfly, but moths are usually nocturnal with feathery antenna, and while sitting, both pairs of wings remain spread horizontally at rest. On the other hand, butterflies are diurnal with club tip antenna, and while sitting, the wings remain close vertically to the body. The moths and butterflies belong to the class Insecta and order Lepidoptera. The larvae of moths and butterflies are called caterpillars. All silkworms are generally belongs to the two families, are Bombycidae and Saturninidae. Students, sericulture is popularly known as agro-based labor-intensive industry. This is because sericulture not only involves the culture of silkworms, but also proper scientific management of the food plants on which the silkworm live. Thus, sericulture industry comprises of various aspects such as cultivation of host plants on scientific basis, collection and production of silkworm eggs, rearing of silkworms, reeling or spinning of yarn or silk thread from the cocoons, fabrication or drying, and finally marketing. If we go back to the history of sericulture, then we have to mention about the discovery and origin of silk. The origin of silkworm and silk threads date back to China about 4000 years ago. According to Confucius literature, in the 27th century BC, a silkworm cocoon fell into the tea cup of the Empress Leizhu from the shade of a tree. The 14-year-old girl, when wanted to take out the cocoon from the cup, she began to unroll the thread of the cocoon. In India, no one really knows when sericulture came, but it exists in Ganga and Brahmaputra belts from time immemorial. According to Western historian, Malabari cultivation spreads to India about 140 BC from China through Tibet, but recent archaeological discoveries in Harappa suggest that sericulture exists in South Asia during the time of the Indus Valley Civilization, dating between 2000 to 2450 BC. Students, I think you all heard about the Silk Road. Silk Road, also called the Silk Road, derives its name from trade in silk on this road. It is a historically international network of trade routes formally established in Han Dynasty of China in 207 to 220 BC, which joined the regions of ancient world in commerce. It is a network of mostly land but also some sea trading routes. Silk was the major trade product besides gold, silver, glass, furs, precious stones, etc. And the fame of Chinese manufactured silk travel across this route. At present, China has declared in 2013 the Chinese Prime Minister to revive this Silk Road in the name of One Belt, One Road project to connect neighbors in the West, Central Asia, the Middle East, and Europe for trade and commerce. This route, extending more than 6,500 kilometers, connect Asia, Europe, Africa along the northern borders of China, India, Persia, and extended up in Eastern Europe near Turkey and Mediterranean Sea. Now we'll be discussing about silk varieties. Across the world, we have four varieties of commercial silk. In India, especially northeastern region of India, we have the all four varieties of silk. Depending on the food habit, the four types of silkworms are classified into two groups, that is mulberry silkworms, which feeds on the leaves of mulberry plant. It is commonly known as Patpolo in Assamese, and the scientific name is Bombyx muri. It belongs to the family Bombycidae and order Lepidoptera, and non-mulberry silkworms, which feeds on varieties of food plants other than mulberry plants as natural food. They are also called wild or boigno silkworms. They belong to the family Saturninidae of the order Lepidoptera. On the other hand, on the basis of nature of life cycle, silk moths are again classified into following three types. Univoltine silk moths. These silk moths complete one life cycle in a year. For example, Bombyx muri. Bivoltine silk moths. These complete two life cycles in a year. Some types of Bombyx and Tussar silkworm produce more than one brood in a year. Multivoltine silk moths. These silk moths complete their life cycles more than two times in a year. For example, Eri and Muga silkworm. In India, including northeastern region of India, we have three types of commercially important non-mulberry silkworms are known, which produce three different types of commercial silk fibers. They are Eri silkworm produces Eri silk fiber, Muga silkworm produces Muga silk fiber, and Tussar silkworm produces Tussar silk fiber. We are discussing about silk varieties. We have four main commercial silk varieties. Firstly, mulberry silk. It is the most superior quality of silk. Most of the commercial silk produced in the world comes from this variety, and often silk refers to mulberry silk produced by Bombyx muri. These silkworms are completely domesticated and reared indoors and feed exclusively on the leaves of mulberry plant. So these are the mulberry silkworm adult stage, food plants, pupin star larva, cocoons, and silk yarn. Muga silk, the silk produced by Anthuria assamensis helper, is popularly known as Muga silk. The silkworm is polyphagous in nature, and its wild counterpart is found in the foothills of Meghalaya, Arunachal Pradesh, and Nagaland, which shows wide range of color morphism and volcanism. So far, 15 numbers of food plants are reported. The main food plants are Sum, Swalu, Digloti, and Mezankeri. Muga silkworm, adult, male, female, larva, food plants, cocoons, mass rearing, and reeled silk yarn. Another important commercial silk varieties is Eri silk. The silk produced by Eri silkum semiaricini donovan is popularly known as Eri silk. The Eri silkworms of the genus Semia contains 19 species across the world, out of which semiaricini is domesticated. The insect is polyphagous in nature, and we all know the agriculture is native to northeastern region of India. So far, 10 numbers of Eri silkworm food plants are reported. The main food plants are castor, keseru, and tapioca. Eri silkworm adult stage, male and female, larva, food plants castor, keseru, and tapioca. Eri silkworm generally produces two different colors of cocoons, white variety cocoons and red variety cocoons, and spun yarn. The fourth variety of commercial silk is tussar silk. It consists of two types, tropical tussar or temperate tussar or oak tussar. In India, tussar silk is produced by the silkworm Anthuria mylita, which consists of 44 ecoregions across the country. The temperate or oak tussar Anthuria proeli feeds mainly on oak leaves. In China, the tussar silkworm Anthuria prairini is reared to produce tussar silk. Similarly, in Japan, the tussar silkworm Anthuria yamamai is reared to produce tussar silk. In northeastern region of India, especially in Manipur, the tussar silkworm Anthuria proeli is reared to produce tussar silk. So, the Anthuria proeli adult, male and female, food plants Quercus species and Pippin star larva, cocoons of tussar silkworm and reeled yarn. Besides four main varieties of silk, we have other silk varieties also. These are Enafe silk. In southern and central Africa, silk produced by Enafe silkworm, for example, Enafe panda. Similarly, Phagara silk, the giant silk moth Attacas atlas produce Phagara silk. Indo-Australian biogeographic regions, China and Sudan, commercially produce Phagara silk. Cone silk, the Syrian silkworm Pispipasa otas produces cone silk. Mosel silk, the silk is obtained from bivalve Pinna squamosa, is called as mosel silk, also known as fish wool. Its production is largely restricted to Toronto in Italy. Spider silk, Madagascan spider species, namely Nephila madagascarensis, Miranda orientia, etc., produces spider silk. Global silk production. If we see the global silk production scenario, in 2015 and 16, global silk production was 152,868 metric ton, China 82.42% and India 15.5%. In Indian silk production in 2015 and 16, Malbari 20,434 metric ton, Tassar 2,818 metric ton, Eri 5,054 metric ton, and Muga 166 metric ton. Now, I would like to mention briefly about the biodiversity of wild silk moth in northeastern region of India. We all know that northeastern region of India, one of the mega biodiversity hotspot and potential center for wild silk moth culture. We have already discussed about the wild silk moth or non-mulberry silk moth. So, wild silk moth or non-mulberry silk moths, also known as boino silks, are in general not reared in captivity. These are charismatic fauna of the insect world, producing porous silk and exhibit variability of life from egg to adult with characteristically different physiological, morphological, and feeding parameter among themselves. Global wild silk moth biodiversity. Present status of wild silk moth: about 1,861 species in 162 genera and 9 subfamilies all over the world. In Asia and Africa, we have 80 species of wild silk moth. In Indian subcontinent from Himalayas to Sri Lanka, we have 50 species of wild silk moth. In India alone, we have 47 species of wild silk moth under 15 genera. In Nagaland, we have 15 species belonging to 8 genera. In northeastern region of India, we have 26 species under 13 genera. Wild silk moth species in northeastern region of India. Under Antheria, we have Antheria asamensis, Antheria proeli, Antheria royali, Antheria pretti, Antheria parini, Antheria halferi, Antheria compta, Antheria mylita, Antheria niviti, Antheria castania. Under genus Actias, we have Actias silini and Actias rhodopneuma. Similarly, genus Attacas, we have Attacas atlas. Genus Archaeotacas, we have Archaeotacas edwardsi. Genus Cricula, we have Cricula trifenestrata. Under genus Lupa, we have Lupa sicima and Lupa catinca. Genus Samia, we have Samia ricini and Samia canningi. Genus Santonexia, we have Santonexia minas. And genus Theophila, we have Theophila religiosa. Under genus Bombyx, we have Bombyx mandarina and Bombyx hotoni. Genus Dendromylas, we have Dendromylas pini. Genus Lebeda, we have Lebeda nobilis. And genus Rhodonia, we have Rhodonia neura. So, under genus Antheria, we have 10 species. Genus Actias, we have 2 species. Genus Attacas, we have 1 species. Genus Samia, we have 2 species. Genus Theophila, we have 1 species. Genus Archaeotacas, we have 1 species. Cricula, we have 1 species. Lopa, we have 2 species. Sondonexia, we have 1 species. Bombyx, we have 2 species. Lebeda, we have 1 species. Rhodonia, we have 1 species. So, total, we have 26 species of wild silk moth in northeastern region of India. I would like to show some wild silk moth species found in northeastern region of India. Antheria asamensis, which produces Muga silk. Actias silini, popularly known as Indian moon moth. Antheria royali, wild counterpart of Tosar silk moth. Similarly, Antheria proeli produces temperate Tosar silk. Antheria species novo, Cricula trifenestrata, popularly known as Amphotogoni. Attacas atlas, the world's largest insect. Theophila religiosa, Antheria pretti, wild Tosar silk moth. Samia canningi, popularly known as wild eri. Antheria mylita, Samia ricini, domesticated eri silk moth. Lopa sicima, Lopa catinca, Archaeotacas edwardsi, Santonexia male and female. larvae of different species of wild silk moth found in northeastern region of India. The larvae exhibit variation between different species. Similarly, cocoon and yarn diversity of wild silk moth found in northeastern region of India. We have already discussed about sericulture and silk varieties with an example of wild silk moth biodiversity in northeastern region of India. So, why is silk important? I have already mentioned that India ranks second next to China, contributing about 15.5% of world production. Sericulture related activities also provide direct employment to about 35 million of people. Commercial muga silk product. Different commercial eri silk product. Different commercial tussar silk product. Besides different types of garments, silk is also used in different cosmetic products and also lots of biomedical applications. I would like to mention recent research approaches, and I am very much proud to mention that an Assamese scientist working on airderm perforation project at Deakin University, Australia, to develop silk-based artificial human airderm. A team of Australian scientists at Deakin University, Australia, headed by Dr. Rangam Raskua, has been working on an innovative concept to help those who have hearing loss due to airderm perforation. They developed silk-based membrane material for an artificial human airderm. They published their work in the Journal of Expert Review Medical Devices. So, these are the suggested readings and references which I have followed for this particular presentation. I hope this presentation will help and guide you, and if you have any queries, please feel free to contact me at email address given. Thank you for a patient hearing.